going full speed down the I-5 as we're in Del Mar, California for men's competition for the five spots to Carson out of the California Regional.
There's a collision occurring.
Ha! Ah, I like collisions.
Four or five guys by.
Duke it out. Ready. I'll make it simple. If I take first place in both workouts, my chances are pretty good, I think.
That's a good game plan.
Like, no, my fuck! So good! No!
He's really fired up.
Now, this weekend is just remembering what dirt tastes like from last year. Will you cry if Dan Bailey doesn't make it?
No, I won't cry.
Wish me luck. I'll see you guys after you're on the floor, okay? I love you.
That was nerve-wracking. I'm still nervous. My heart is racing.
Who's this guy?
This guy, this is Brandon Domain, the other sexy voice in CrossFit.
Have you ever worked with him on a live feed before?
None of the regionals or the games events, but like other events we've done, smaller events, yeah.
Brandon, who's going to win the men's individual this year?
I mean, it's always hard to say that Dan's not going to do it.
If Kenny's hamstring can hang in there, I know he injured his hamstring about a month or so back. If he's feeling okay, I think the events are great for him, so I think he would go.
I like Christian Lucero moving in. Rasmus is somebody that can move in.
How about Garrett Fisher?
I saw Garrett in a couple events earlier this year, and I think he'll make it back. You know the one who, like, again, who we don't ever really talk about much is Marcus Philly. Like, that kid's a stud. And he took last year off, but his fitness is pretty unbelievable. Dan, Josh, Kenny, Garrett, Marcus.
Okay.
Not in that order.
Step over the prior bar. So meaning like you're going to go to that last barbell and you got to move that forward. So when you're done with the first barbell, step over it. Don't go around it. And then when you finish, the same. Step over it to the finish. Yeah.
Good.
Is that your coach?
Not my coach. I don't have a coach, man. He's just a good dude.
You don't have a coach?
Nope. I ate three eggs, a piece of potato bread, and avocado. And then a burrito that had hamburger, sweet potato, rice, and asparagus in it.
Today?
Yeah.
But it's not even noon barely.
I like to party, man. I like to party.
How many cups of coffee?
Just one. I was going to get a second one, but I decided against it. I don't really need the adrenaline right now. I feel pretty good. I'm pretty fired up.
Had three eggs. Two pieces of toast, three pieces of bacon. What else?
And then
some Chipotle. No, I haven't had coffee. Not a big coffee guy.
You had any caffeine?
I've got a little in my pre-workout that I'm drinking right now.
Oh, you get a Chipotle?
Yeah, Chipotle.
A burrito on top of all that other stuff?
Yeah, no, a burrito bowl. Not all of it. I try to eat all of it, but it's hard to eat right before you compete. I like to feel full though before I compete. So that's about it.
That's weird. Why do you like to feel full before you compete?
I've just always been that way. Ever since I was competing in like high school before. I never liked going out on an empty stomach. I've never thrown up working out. I've passed out from working out, but never thrown up or anything, so my stomach was alright.
How'd you pass out? What happened then?
In the open workout with the squat clean thrusters. On my last thruster, like, I watched the video, like, I pretty much fall over and the bar almost hits me in the head. I'm like, that pass out there? Like, I'm not sure if I did or not. And then Murph almost passed out during Murph.
Oh.
At the game.
Nerves are in full swing right now.
They're awake and going?
Yeah. They decided to come with me down to San Diego. I tried to leave them at home.
Hear from people that, like, they feel the pressure from their family and friends who supported them through all their training when they're out there. Do you feel that?
I think just being here as an athlete and the relationships I have with them, like, you can't let them down, you know? Like, I come out here to, you know, pursue something that I love, and I think that's what they're inspired by. And whether I get first or get last, they're going to be stoked, you know?
Yeah.
And how did you make that decision?
Are you injured? Yeah, I have lots of shoulder injuries. Like three tears in each of my labrums, so I don't weightlift.
The shirt that was holding him back.
And I just need to get through the weekend without being hurt. So I'm actually happy that I did the first one without failing. Like that.
You did do one.
That's my success. Yes, I did one.
Did they tell you you had to do one?
Yeah, it's the minimum.
One rep.
Right. Are girls lifting that much? Are there?
What do you think about how Ronnie Teasdale sat out that first event? He only did one rep.
I mean, it's a bold strategy.
I don't think it's bad. I mean, he's got his goals. His goal is not necessarily to make it in the top three. He just wants to come here and have some fun.
It was exciting for me to come out and just do one because I don't have the experience of being last place in front of all these people. So I'm kind of happy that I've gained this.
How's everybody's macros?
This, quote, humbling experience, right?
What's cool about Ronnie is he's the one that every single time they do a work, they do the open, he's the first decent athlete that puts a score out there and it actually sets the bar for everyone to be like, okay, this is a good score, that's not a good score. I got to hand it to him for that. And he's just, I mean, he's been around a long time.
It's not a victorious part of my life. And it probably shouldn't be documented.
Too late.
Ready?
Yeah, I feel ready. Yeah.
Did you miss the games last year?
I did. I missed it 2 years in a row.
You said, did you miss it?
Oh, like last year I had other things going on. I missed it, but I was occupied with other ordeals. So I guess you say I didn't. To answer your question, I didn't miss it as much as maybe some people would think so, because I was busy with other things in life.
What did you have going on that distracted you?
So I was personal training Rick Ross, the rapper. So I was with him every day, traveling with him as much as I could, and then not being at a home gym in a foreign environment wasn't the most ideal.
That was both years?
Actually, that was towards the end of 2014. So when I first started working with him was about a month prior to 2014 regionals, and then I was with him for almost a year. Yeah.
And are you still doing that?
I am not, no more. Yeah, there's some he got in some legal troubles.
So he's not training?
I see him on Instagram. He's still been rowing a little bit. I don't know what he's doing, but I'm not training with him no more.
Did you pick up any skills, like lyrical skills, hanging with him? I'm smoking dope. I'm on my cell phone.
I'm selling dope straight off the iPhone. No, nothing. Nothing.
Am I clear to you?
Good to be here?
Yeah. Feels good.
Yeah, I bet.
Be a part of it, but not kill myself anymore.
Right.
Help these guys out.
And how old are you?
I just turned 25.
Is it hard to get back into the level of training it takes to go to the games?
Not for me. I knew what it takes to get there. 2013 had a great year, so I knew exactly what it took to get to the game. So it wasn't too hard for me to turn it on again.
How many people are you coaching these days?
I really just coach Garrett and Nathan Bramlett individually, and then I do that icon athlete thing, so like a big kind of universal programming for anybody that wants to compete, which is cool because I can help out a variety of competitors, but really this stuff really just focused on a couple people.
Yeah, I knew my fitness wasn't there, but I knew life took me other places, so I wasn't too like bummed about it in a way.
How much does it have to slip to fall out of games caliber?
A lot. Just a little bit. It's getting so tough every year, just in the open. One bad workout in the open, you're not going to regionals, and one bad workout in regionals, you're not going to the game. So it's just a little bit. Everybody's training 24/7 now, so it's a full-time job.
Are you feeling stressed out for them?
No, I think just because like I know he's prepared, you know? He's done his job, so it's cool to see. No, it's just get to be a part of it and watch it happen.
This workout out here, what's What's Garrett Fisher think this first workout, this snatch?
So we can have some go out there, have fun, and just control the controllables. Like this snatch workout, it's a good workout for me, so I'm just gonna do what I need to do, not worry about nobody else. Just laser beam focused. It's on me this whole weekend.
Why Chris Spieler as a coach? There's so many great coaches out there.
Yeah, I've known of Chris for, I mean, obviously we're both sponsored by Progenix. I don't know, it just seemed like a good fit, and I reached out to him, and he was wanting to help, so it was good.
As successful as you were at the games, he's such a different physique than you.
Yeah.
Does that make programming for him, you have to think outside of your box, or?
No, it's just knowing, I think, how to effectively program. Just programming smart, right? It's just programming for people's strengths or what they need to work on, and paying attention to that, and it's a team effort. You know, he gives me feedback, which is super helpful. Anybody that's just trying to do it without feedback from their athlete, I think it's kind of a mistake, so.
I'm actually gonna lunge it to the next stations, drop it down on my back, hold it there, pick the weights up, slide them on, pop it off, and then touch it, catch it, touch and go again, like a 32-year-old would do.
Yeah, youngster.
Old guys like me, we don't do that. We'll be 34 this year, bro, okay? I'm just gonna do it normal and finish in 7 minutes.
Whatever. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Oh, dude. If I don't finish the ladder, my little kids are gonna start crying. They're gonna cry. My baby girls will just start crying. They'll know what's going on. If they saw your mustache, they'd probably cry too.
That's what it's there for.
It's there to show everyone who the boss is. When my first son was born, I was like, I had a mustache, and I was like, he needs to know who the boss is when he comes out, and now he knows.
No. Time on that workout.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah, no, I can hit a bit more than that. But I think that was a PR for Josh.
Or close to it, man.
He was digging.
And I kept seeing him. No, I don't know those people. Cool. I kind of know him now. I kept seeing Josh make reps next to me. And I know this is probably not the way to think about it, but I was like, Josh is smaller than me. I have to keep making reps because he's making them.
That was inspiring for sure to watch him do that.
You didn't even take first and we got a celebration.
I just, dude.
Oh, no way! Are you not kidding me? No way! Josh Bridges!
Makes no one fuck so good! No!
Get away!
That was a good one. That was a double PR right there.
It's good that he got it out of the way early because, you know,
That's like the momentum swing when Josh does the big fist pump. And if it comes later in the competition, it's super intimidating. But when you're already sitting on the finish mat and he does it, I'm just like, good for you, man. Good for you. We're doing all right.
So, I was happy.
That was a snatch PR for a double?
Well, yeah. Like, I've never hit 265 before, so hit it twice. Fucking stoked.
Who's going to take first place in the men?
As of right now, after today, I'll say this. I think after today, Josh Bridges will be in first out of day, after day one.
I think with Josh doing what he did in that first event, when he's that good at the events that he shouldn't be that good in, that's terrifying for everybody else. So I would say Josh at this point.
Yeah, that boy, way to go. Good stuff, buddy. That's awesome.
When you're out there and you're beating up on yourself, like after you missed that one.
I was actually telling myself, you got this. The weight actually felt really good. I just missed it forward, but I was like, okay. It was actually a motivator, and I was just trying to stay positive in my head. And man, it looked like I was getting angry, but I was actually like being positive, which is not like myself, especially when I snatch. Typically pretty negative. So that was awesome.
I was screaming good.
I heard you.
Like, it's all good. I'm like, you got this.
Yeah, thank you, brother.
Thank you. Dan, PR for you?
No. In the snatch, no. Time, yeah. I think it was the fastest we've done it.
What is your heaviest snatch?
280.
And how long ago was that you did that?
Last year.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in the since then, what's your heaviest one been?
275.
Okay.
So, but, I mean, for that, like, I'm not as fluid as other people in those movements, so that's a lot of snatches. So it catches up to me pretty quick. So I kind of just did my thing. I tried to ignore what's going on, do my thing, and not miss the 265. Only missed once, so not bad. But
did you get a no rep?
No.
How about that one where you came super far forward? They didn't no rep you?
No, that was a no rep because I couldn't. It was okay that I ran with it, but I didn't stand it up all the way.
Huh? Are you surprised you finished?
No, I did it twice before this, and I finished both times. But that was without having to like roll the barbell all over the place and do those things. So I'm pretty pumped in my time. That was by far the best.
So when you practiced this with Josh, he didn't finish?
No, he always got to the 265, and he did like a deadlift at 265, and he's like, I'm good.
So when you did the snatch workout with Dan, what did you do when you got to the 265 bar?
I did some pulls.
I
tried to make the weight feel light.
He's like, I'm not going to get it. And we just kept saying, like, you're going to get it on game day. Like, who cares? You know? So he did. Suck it. Just pumped.
So you didn't even try him?
I actually did. I don't even think I took an attempt at it. No, I just did some pulls on it. So I wanted to make the weight feel light on my pulls, and I would do every time I do it afterwards, I'd put 260 on and I would just do pulls with it, try to make it feel light. And I was like, I tried to get as high as I could, right? So I just do those like little panda pulls, I guess. So now just really banking on the crowd out there, you know, like, or the adrenaline, and it paid off.
What were you doing?
Nothing.
Nah.
No, I wasn't.
You should have been.
Rumor has it you're going to be on The Bachelor. Is that true?
Yes. Yes, that is true. Dan is going to be on The Bachelor. You have to be.
Why?
The world needs Dan Bailey.
I tell you what, it would be the most interesting season of The Bachelor they've ever had. It would not be a standard season.
This is your first time going as an individual in the regionals.
Yeah.
What's the biggest shock so far about being here?
Here? Right before we went out that workout, I looked around and I looked at who I was around. I was like, wow. It's a privilege to be next to these guys, you know, that you watch, that you, you know, idolize and that you want to be like. I just looked around and there's, you know, Dan and Josh and, you know, Rasmus and Christian Lucero. Like, just like, wow. And Garrett Fisher. Like, I never thought that I would be right next to them going out on the floor with them. So it was a shock, but it was like more of a privilege, you know, to be with them.
Is this on film?
Yes.
I messed my hamstring up like a little while ago. and like a month ago, so it was like something that I was doing to heal it. I had really great like PT work done by like Travis Connolly and the Dosi, and Kathy Flippin like was my massage therapist, and they worked on me constantly the past 4 weeks, like pretty much three times a week. And it's, I didn't think I was gonna be able to get here, dude, but they've gotten me to the point where I can perform and pretty confidently. So
yeah, it was by far one of the coolest things.
I think he's twerking, dude.
It's just awesome. It wakes up your whole body, and it just loosens up your muscles. I use it as a cool down, but I've been kind of exploring the whole shaking thing. It's pre-human, right? That term, shake it off, right? That means something. Animals, if they're hurt, they go to their den and they just shake. They shake their injuries away. They shake their sicknesses away. If there's people training with me, I always try and get everyone to do it, because we should do it, actually. Because, man, I was at a yoga class last week, and we were doing shaking. It's the first time I ever had anyone else do it to me, and we shook for like 4 minutes.
Someone who, like me, who has never done any shaking, is 4 minutes excessive for my first shake?
No, we gotta go 10 minutes.
I'll do a 10-minute shake, and I'll report back to you.
I wanna help you through it, though. There's some guidance. Like, how to get out of it is important. Mostly just shaking the whole time.
I'm not gonna get stuck after 8 minutes of shaking. I'll be like the coyote in that one cartoon where he swallows the jackhammer, you know, and he's just, you know, he does shakes every once in a while. You know that episode?
Yeah, they do that. And he's like,
yeah.
Meep meep.
When they announced Nate, I was like, awesome. And they said strict, and I was like, okay. Like, I think everyone's gonna have the same issues.
You're pretty heavy. It's not like you're light.
No, I don't think I'm like 175. I'm not a heavy guy, but I'm not a light guy.
It's heavy for how tall you are.
Right, yeah.
I mean, so, if you were 10 pounds lighter, you could do muscle-ups a lot more.
Yeah, right. My muscle-ups actually gotten really good. I was actually like stoked. I was like, okay, cool, a lot of muscle-ups. Like, or it could be a lot of muscle-ups, depending on how they do it. I said strict. I was like, okay, I can do strict muscle ups. I'm not scared. It's gonna be a fun workout. It's kind of a slow workout though. Like, you can't really like push it too hard because you have to be able. You can't miss the reps.
What's funny is we go from, I think you need to be a very good lifter, a very powerful, explosive lifter, to someone that can move body weight stuff really, really well. I mean, I wouldn't say it's like full blown just gymnast only kind of thing, but I think the smaller guys are gonna have the advantage on this next workout. I mean, the smaller athletes, the lighter athletes, I think will have the advantage over guys like Rasmus or some of the bigger athletes. It's a lot of weight you gotta move.
Don't be afraid to start that
hurry. Yeah.
Lean back more.
Yeah.
And then tight as you sit through.
Four, I'm going to take my box.
One, two, straight handstand push up. And then I want six jump squats.
I thought you would, I've seen a picture of you before and thought you were more like Warlock-esque.
So I saw you today, or yesterday, I was like, I think that's Sevan, but he's so clean shaven, I don't even know if that's him. I thought you were like the Gandalf of CrossFit.
How did you end up in California region? You duck in the south over there? Got too hard for you over there?
No, I'm from here. I'm from Encinitas, so I had to come back to my old stomping grounds. Can't let all these boys have all this fun out here without me, right?
Right, right. What did you think about your open performance?
I liked it. You know, it was good. Good enough to get here. That's all you want, right, to get to that next spot. Don't put too much value in the open as far as placement, as long as you make it to regionals and you're in that last heat, just to keep you competitive. Didn't let it get to my head too much. Like, just keep grinding and know that I still got a long way to go. So keep working my ass off.
How old are you?
Just turned 23.
And how tall are you?
5'9". I put 5'10 on my my stat card.
On my football.
Yeah, my football stat card.
To intimidate people?
Yeah.
And how much do you weigh?
I'm about 185 right now, 187.
And how long have you been CrossFitting?
I've been CrossFitting for 3 years. A little bit lighter right now, but getting stronger. So, shit, I'll be leaner and stronger any day. I'll take that.
Workout for you?
We do CrossFit, so they all should be good workouts for us, right?
Did you know where Josh was?
Towards the end, yeah. I felt him creeping, like Michael Myers, but just tried to like stay with my game plan and be confident and not make adjustments for anybody else. Keep the blinders on and keep working.
When you thought about day one, were you hoping it would go this well for you?
Yeah. I mean, every day I feel like this is gonna get stronger and stronger. So I don't feel like this is the ceiling, but I thought this would be a pretty good day for me.
Were you ever concerned during the muscle ups? I saw you got no rep at least once. Were you ever concerned that you were gonna get stopped?
No, because I think I'm pretty good at knowing where to push and how to fix little adjustments in my gymnastics to keep the refs happy. So
I did exactly what I said I shouldn't do. I was feeling good at the beginning, went a little too deep. I went a little too deep on the first five rounds.
unbroken sets.
Early on.
Yeah, I was like round four. Yeah.
You got stopped.
I just lost my rhythm. Like I wasn't getting engaged before I went. I felt it three times in a row. I was like, I really have to focus when I do it to put my feet together. And if I don't slam my feet together and try to press them together, I do that. And that's what I did in training a ton. And I really focused on it every night. And I was like, I stepped back for a second. I was like, you know what you're doing. Relax and then keep going.
What kind of relief is there that day one is done? Is there a massive relief? Or
I don't know if I'd say a massive relief. The workout tomorrow mornings is the worst workout of the weekend, the most painful.
And what is that?
I've been 3 and 4. The wall ball, pull up.
With this small break?
Yeah, into the pistol clean. That is by far the most painful workout of the weekend.
How you doing, Dan?
Huh? Oh, check doing? In right now?
Not happy.
You're not?
No.
Did you finish that in practice?
I don't know. It doesn't matter. I didn't finish it either.
Threshold.
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning.
Hi, Sevan.
You've had a busy day already.
Busy day of living.
Yeah. So you did slacklining already this morning?
Yeah. And then I went in the ocean, unicycled to the ocean, then went in the ocean.
I mean, is that excessive? Like, don't you think you should pace yourself? You're in the CrossFit Regionals, you're going to have a busy day with a lot of movement already. Maybe you should have slept in and...
You know, every day I get up and I like to move. Whatever I do later on in the day is made better by moving in the morning. Lots of, you know, fitness leaders talk about getting up and doing something immediately. So that's actually why I have the unicycle, because it gives me something to do right when I wake up. If I wake up in the morning and have to go to the gym, I can unicycle there and immediately get my blood flowing, hormones, energy up, because unicycling is not easy.
If you were to give someone advice who wants to start unicycling, what would it be? Something you wish someone would have told you about it?
Well, all I did was go on Google how to unicycle, and I found like a 1 minute clip. And all it takes is learning to fail well, and you have to do that for hours.
So tell me about yesterday. Are you surprised where you're at?
I'm surprised I'm in first, I'll be honest. I thought that those are two good events for me. Like, if there were two events that I wanted to see come up first, it was those two events. It let me build some momentum going into day two. But day two for me is just a kick in the nuts, man. It's going to be the pistols. You know, I got a funky knee issue I've been dealing for a while. I'm going to get through them, but it's going to slow me down a little bit. But just yesterday in general was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Can Ben Alderman go to the games?
I would love to see Ben go to the games. I think Ben is a better athlete than... He's a better, well-rounded athlete than I think he's known for. Obviously, a strong powerhouse athlete. But watching him yesterday in the gymnastic-y type event, I mean, that was awesome. He did great. So I'd love to see him go.
Do you want to go to the games?
Yes. Yes, I absolutely want to go to the games. I mean, before this year, it was like all or nothing CrossFit Games. Now, you know... I just adopted two little baby girls. I run two gyms. You know, I'm coming up on 34 years old, so I'm kind of like accepted if it doesn't happen. So I took all the pressure off myself this year, you know? But I love competing. I love training. And then the byproduct of that is you just want to test yourself. And so if I'm doing it right, then I'll go. I said on my social media, I said, hey, you know, I'm not here to beat everyone. I'm just here to keep everybody honest. You know, if you take your foot off the gas or you slow up on a workout, don't give it 100%, I'm going to beat you. But because I'm going to do that. I'm going to give it 100% every time. That's really, I see my role here this weekend.
What's your best finish prior to this? Ever, like at the end of the weekend?
Seventh. Last year I was ninth. Had Dave not combined the regions last year, I'd been second at the NorCal guys. I could have went to the games already.
So. Thanks, Dave.
Yeah, right? His fault. I'm half Filipino, half white. So I get Mexican all the time, but half Filipino, half white.
And Alderman is your dad?
My dad, yeah.
Got it. He's the white guy?
He's the white guy.
What ethnicity are you?
I'm 50% Filipino, and then my father is white, German, Irish, and Dutch.
Like Ben Alderman.
Is that what he is?
Yeah, his like dad is white, and his mom is Filipino.
It's like, yeah. My parents look like John Smith and Pocahontas.
What's your ethnicity?
I'm Basque.
100%.
Basque and Spanish. Yeah. But we won't mention the Spanish part.
Gotcha.
They hate each other. So I'll just claim Basque.
Do you have internal conflict?
Yes, all the time.
Caucasian? White?
No, you got
American?
No, what are you?
My mom's side is Polish and Irish, and my dad's side is a mix. I know he has some Native American in him. I don't know how much. I think he's German too. I'm a pretty big mutt.
How did the controversy around your open video affect you?
It didn't.
Did you end up redoing it?
No. I'd submitted it. I got it like approved kind of thing through CrossFit. They said it was okay. And then obviously time expired. I was announced as the winner. And then I asked Dave when Dave called me and told me that they were going to do the reduction. And I asked him, I was like, well, can I go to the gym right now and I'll call you back in, you know, 30 minutes to tell you what I got and redo it? And he said no. So
they did give you a reduction?
Yeah, 15%.
Oh.
I would have won the open if they wouldn't have.
Is that painful?
Not really. It's not the goal. The goal is to win the games. The open's just like another competition, so you always want to win, but it's not the goal.
What do you think about social media and the scrutiny that every fucking Tom, Dick, and Harry can chime in on every subject?
It's their God-given right.
Did you go back and watch the event?
No, I was told I shouldn't go back and watch it.
Ah. So you know where that question's going, huh?
Yeah. I was told I shouldn't go back and watch other people's reps.
Right. So you didn't go back and watch?
I didn't.
I don't think that Josh was kipping. The definition of the kip that was given was using the hips as an advantage. What I did see was that he would whip his head quite a bit, so there was more movement at the shoulder going this way rather than feet coming up and popping the hips, which would be the classic kip. I did see that, but...
Was it hard not to kip?
Not really. I mean, I guess I don't know what constitutes as a kip. Because everybody, I got done, everybody, I had, I don't know, 3, 4, 5, a handful of people approach me and say, wow, you really did strict muscle-ups. And I'm just like, what does that mean? They're all supposed to be strict. Like, I don't understand what people are saying because I'm not watching everybody else. So I don't know what they did. I don't really want to know, you know?
I don't think that it was Josh got away with murder because Josh is Josh or anything like that. There's always going to be subjectivity, and I think the strict muscle-up in general is going to have subjectivity in it anyway if you're looking for a strict, because I think the guys were all held to about the same standard. I think the girls were all held to about the same standard. And whenever you have judges, you're going to have some subjectivity, and I don't think he got away with murder. I think he did great.
Are you prepared to just go to the death today again? Just like back at it?
And yeah, just go back at it. That's what it takes. So,
what's the worst you've ever done in a regional?
Third?
When it required you to be top three?
Yeah.
So you've come in right at the...
Yeah. Central East, third was the worst I've ever done, I think.
Will you cry if Dan Bailey doesn't make it?
No, I won't cry.
All right.
I mean, I'd be bummed for him, but sorry, Dan. I only cry for other things. I don't know if I would cry for that. I mean, sports is sports.
Is Brandon going to cry if Dan doesn't make it?
Dan, he might cry if Dan doesn't make it.
Any concerns, like when you look at the numbers, that you're so far out that it's not?
I'm trying to think about it. Don't let the worry about the end of the weekend before it's even here. You know, focus on the next event, whatever's coming up.
Have you washed these during, like last night, did you wash those?
Never. I don't wash these because I smell good. I don't wear deodorant. I don't use soap, shampoo, conditioner, none of that stuff.
You just shower just with fresh water.
This weekend, I'm just showering in the ocean.
Everyone has their own form of recovery. Did you guys see how Ronnie Teasdale recovers? Can I show you?
There we go. Good.
Seen enough.
I don't need to see it.
What do you mean this is his recovery? Is that how you recover?
No, it's not.
I do get body work, but it doesn't. I don't wear my underwear like that.
It just happened, and when things like that come into your life, you just receive. You just receive and you don't ask questions. So yeah, it's been a good weekend for me. Everything's been magical.
What did you eat this morning?
Three eggs, three pieces of bacon, two pieces of toast, and avocado.
Same thing you did yesterday?
Yeah, it'll be the same thing every day.
Is that your competition food, or that's just everyday food?
That's pretty much every day. It doesn't change much from that. Yeah.
Do you have a kind of avocado you prefer, like Haas Organic Large or a...
No.
No.
As long as it's not brown and gross.
Just a green dimply thing that looks like a giant scrotum.
Right.
All right.
You said it, not me.
Are you happy with your picks yesterday? In terms of, are you sticking with them? Dan Bailey, Josh Bridges, Kenny Leverage, Garrett Fisher, and Marcus. Stover.
You know what? I still like my picks. I'm not sure how Kenny's doing on this one. I know he's coming off of an injury. I wasn't sure how he's going to do. I thought he would have done better on the last event, the muscle-up event. Who's impressing me, who was kind of on my bubble, was Christian Lucero, just because I thought he was going to be more of a strength athlete. But, man, he looked insane. I mean, watching that race with him and Josh Bridges at the end was really cool. Kid's a stud. He's a stud. You know, not like he's a brand new guy, because that's not the case. He's been around for a handful of years. But I think he's going to do great in these events.
So, like, with the mask, we're not trying to get any type of, like, real, like, elevation training or any bullshit like that. We're really just actually working his breathing. So strengthening his diaphragm, getting him not bottoming out his breath.
Okay.
So then he knows where his...
So to force him to control it.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. And I would say the only difference for a 23-year-old is mostly the recovery afterwards, eating mostly, you know, because sometimes they don't eat. So whereas a older 29, 33, they'll know that they need the food, whereas a kid would just be like, fuck it, I'll deal with it.
How do you choose a coach?
Somebody that understands you, I think, as an athlete, as a person, more specifically, because, you know, your coach has to know what makes you tick, has to know what gets you fired up, what gets you down, what motivates you, how to work with you as an athlete. They have to really be, like, more of a friend that is also a good coach. I think you have to find someone that's both, for sure.
The first victory, was that bittersweet?
Yeah.
Meaning you thought you had it and you had to go back.
I thought he said one more. I did one more. And then he called me back. Gotta adjust, gotta go back, do it. Get it done. I'm learning, Sevan. It's all about learning.
It seems like in your CrossFit career, those were very important two events for you.
Very. My coach said, focus on these two. Nothing else. Not the next one. Not the next one. Not any of the other events. This one. These two. It was good. Exactly.
How you feel?
Good. I feel good, meow. You know, just had a really good night of sleep, meow, and a couple breakfasts in, meow, and just having a good time, day two, meow.
Meow, I'm gonna have to give you a ticket on this.
But
no buts, meow. That's the law. Not so funny, meow, is it?
Meow.
Were you sore this morning?
No, I woke up. The only thing I was sore from was had a little stiff bed, but stretched a little bit, felt awesome.
After watching your performance in the muscle up workout yesterday, these two seem like they could be right in your wheelhouse.
I feel like they're all in my wheelhouse. So just like yesterday, stick to the game plan and just do me. So that's what I'm here to do.
Two things, just make sure that you wait for the beat for the second event, and then we ask that you don't throw your bar forward on power cleans.
Drop it, roll.
Drop it, roll, or walk.
Cool, thanks, got that.
What? Wait for the beat for the second event, and then don't drop your bar, don't push your bar forward when you advance it.
What do you mean,
don't throw it forward, okay. Yeah.
Thank you. After number 10, I have to put it down and then move it?
Or you can walk it, or walk it. Thank you, just don't shove it.
Won a regional event before?
No. That's impressive. Josh?
The back-to-back workouts to win the second one?
And to give a solid interview.
Oh.
Feels good to come away with some pretty good scores. You know, getting a victory is always good. Hey.
Josh, were you ever like, after the first event, and you... Wait, what did you take in that one? Second, third?
Tenth.
Second?
Oh, wait, the first one, just now?
Yeah.
Third.
Were you happy with that right off the bat, or were you disappointed, or were you like, hey, man, I should win that, or?
You know, I didn't know because of the wall balls. I knew it would make up a little bit of time on the pull-ups, so I wasn't sure how the wall balls would go. I got, like, on the right side, the mat kind of lifts, and so I got a little funky, and I couldn't find a good rhythm on my last set, and so I dropped it, and then I just basically had to grip to those pull-ups. So, happy with third. I wasn't upset with third. Third's not a bad place. So, and then really stoked for the last one. You gotta get first on that.
Yeah,
I saw you. I saw you hit the cleans. Or no, you hit the pistols before I moved up to my pistols. Yeah. So we were in the same first set, and so then I picked it up.
Yeah.
I was like,
what was your time on the whole thing?
I don't remember. I kind of walked through it.
I just me too.
Yeah, I walked through it. I saw Hank coming up, and I was like, I'll just walk through this.
Bridges has momentum.
Gets fired up. He's really fired up. It's a deadly thing. And I mean, he's already such a mentally strong guy. But momentum and confidence and then ability on top of that, that's gnarly.
Inspiration. Do you need any inspiration, or is this just come naturally to you? Is there anything you have to do, pep talk yourself?
I talk to myself for sure. I try to stay positive. I try to think about things that keep me motivated, you know? Things that got me where I am, so. Yeah, for sure.
Anything particular this weekend? Does it change?
No. No, this weekend is just remembering what dirt tastes like from last year, you know, and not wanting to taste that again.
Whatever happens, happens. It was a great fun. Gosh damn, these regionals are getting way more competitive. Good? Not good? Oh, yeah. Nope, sixth.
That's really one of the main things I'm thinking about is like, not wanting to taste dirt, going home, feeling like a loser.
What will you eat now before the next event?
Yeah, I'll have a little bit of food for sure.
What will you eat?
What?
What will you eat?
Just probably a little bit of hamburger, a little bit of vegetables, not much. I still don't want to have like too much in my gut for this next workout.
Someone was, what's that called? Video bombing you.
Oh, cool.
Christian Lucero.
Oh, nice.
What advice do you have for anyone who wants to get into this full-time, this CrossFit, going to the games mentality?
Be willing to suffer. Be willing to enjoy pain. You know, learn to love it. Like, being strong and one rep maxes, a lot of people are willing to go there because it doesn't hurt as bad, nearly as bad. But being willing to take pain and really start to enjoy it.
That's the whole, you're like 25%?
This is a very wet hug.
She's 75 on 25.
Good job, babe.
Where do you guys live now?
Mill Valley. Right? Yeah. Cool. Mill Valley, California.
Are you nervous at all when you see him out there compete?
Yeah, definitely. That was nerve-wracking.
Like, are you?
I'm still nervous. My heart is racing.
Are you ever concerned he might hurt himself?
Not in a workout like that. I don't really worry about that.
More like suspended from a 30-foot rope?
That is a little bit scarier. With the deadlifts, I might be a little bit nervous, but I wasn't going to tell him that before that, although I just did. But that kind of workout makes me more nervous than like what we just saw.
What's a rest day look like for Marcus?
Some sunning, maybe some walking or a hike. Or a jog, or around the world.
What's around the world? Basketball game?
We do that sometimes.
Is moving between a number of different movements, so like aerodyne, rowing, plank, jump rope, that kind of thing.
That's an in the gym recovery session.
The pull-ups.
No, this was from the kettlebell yesterday. So this just. No, it's just skin. No, that'll feel nice. It'll actually like give it, it'll lock it in a little better. The skin will wrap around it a little bit more. It'll give it a little groove to sit in.
Are you always so optimistic?
Yeah, I mean, that's why we do this, right? I do this to have fun. I do this to maximize my potential as a human being. And if you're not having fun with it, you know, I don't know why you're doing it, because if you're not having fun, this sucks.
Are you having fun?
Oh, having so much fun. This year, I don't know, like, it's different from this year from last year. It's just, I think the workout's more fun this year. And I think the atmosphere's better. I'm less nervous, less stressed than I was last year. And again, the workout's amazing. This year is really fun to compete.
Why do you think you're less stressed?
Because you don't have a deficit handstand push-ups on day three.
That's not true. I'm less stressed because this is my second year. Like, last year was like, kind of my first year as individual, like my first year where I'm like, what's competitive? It's my second year being an individual, competitive, and trying to make it to the games. And just being here before and like knowing what it's about makes me less nervous, more calm.
Is Rasmus gonna make it?
I don't think that he will. Not saying he's not a great athlete. I just don't know if with the events that are left, I think the other athletes are gonna be better in those events. So I don't know if he's gonna make it or not this year. I mean, he's looking great, but I just don't know if he'll make it.
You were in it until the very last day last year, right?
Yeah.
Was it the final event?
It was second final, like first event on the last day.
That kind of pushed you out.
It did, yeah.
Did you think you were, at any point last year, did you think you were, hey, I have this wrapped up, or were you nervous going into the final day?
I was nervous. I knew my handstand push-ups last year wasn't good, so I wasn't surprised. I was just hoping that I would be able to, like, kind of get the rush and the adrenaline going from being out there on the floor and then magically, like, do some handstand push-ups. Unfortunately, it didn't happen, so I blew up kind of what I was expecting. Unfortunately, like everyone else was really good at handstand push-ups last year in that workout, so it just cost me like a lot of points. I wasn't surprised, I was bummed out, but I kind of knew it, so I've really been working on that this year.
How old are you?
23.
How much do you weigh?
205.
And how much did you weigh last year?
215.
And how tall are you?
5'11".
Yeah, you look a little leaner.
I'm definitely leaner this year. Like, I've been working with a nutritionist, Adi. And it's been helping a lot. I mean, it's been hard, but it's definitely, like, helped. And I can just tell, like, everything is easier.
Maybe you weren't even gonna pick that up.
Me too. I didn't do any in warm-up. I just wanted to see how it would feel out there.
I was thinking, just due to the fact that maybe you didn't want to hurt yourself or pick up heavy shit, I was like, oh, I bet you Ronnie's not even gonna pick that up.
I already pulled that card this weekend though. But after the first round, it was very hard to keep on going.
Are you in pain?
Yeah. It's like spine pain. Not even muscular, but like my spine.
Is 405 heavy?
405 is heavy, yeah. I don't know what other guys are saying, but 405 is heavy.
Is 405 heavy?
Unfortunately it is, yeah. I think, especially after true form, I think most people are gonna be surprised how much the true form is gonna blow up the lower back and quads, I think, hamstrings. I'm a little nervous about that. So we'll see. Be fun, but it's gonna be heavy.
In the last year, what's the heaviest deadlift you've done in the last year?
Last year?
Probably like 455.
Is that gonna give Josh Bridges any problems?
I talked to him about that, he said no. He's like, you know, everyone from the games, everyone was saying that I can't do 405 pounds. What they forget is I did 13 of the 15. So it wasn't like I couldn't move the weight, I just didn't get them all done that day. He's one of those guys, I think, that if there's something that he did bad in or that people think he's not going to be able to do, he's going to make sure he fixes that. He told me, he's like, that'll never happen again. I'm going to blast through the 405. It's like, watch me. All right.
I hear in the years past, there's been smaller athletes who are on the smaller end, who they're always like talking about big man versus small man versus big man workouts. I don't really hear you. You didn't complain about the wall ball. You're not complaining about the heavy deadlift.
Yeah, I like going up against workouts. I guess people think that I shouldn't do well at. And that's their opinion. So I like those workouts. I like to be tested. I don't want Dave Castro to put workouts that are, I guess some people would say, built for me. I like to test with myself and see how I compare to everyone else.
But you also really want to win.
Of course. Of course I really want to win. But I'd rather win in a fashion where people don't expect me to win. I mean, if every fucking workout was Fran out there and I walked away, it wouldn't be satisfying either way, winning or losing. You'd be like, yeah, of course I should have won, you know?
All you can say is Josh Bridges is back.
He's 405 heavy?
Yeah. With all the other stuff, yeah.
Do you ever, what's the most you've lifted in the last year, deadlifted?
Just a regular deadlift, probably around 520, 525.
In the last year you've done that?
Yeah.
Wow, okay. Yeah. Is Dan still in it?
Yeah. He's 9 points out of fifth. And it's always that way. I mean, what he's going to be able to do is do the best that Dan can do. What he can't control is what these other guys are going to do. And I think that's what's been happening so far. When you have Christian and Garrett and Henry Lopez that are doing really, really well, can't control what they're doing, you know? So
competition Dan versus Dan, like we're hanging out eating a sandwich Dan. Are they two different people?
What do you think?
I think they are. That's why I'm asking.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I'm at my most stressful point in work. If I were to be interviewing you while you're interviewing behind the scenes at the games and I ask you a bunch of questions, I'd probably get pretty short answers.
And as he tries to move into one of those five qualifying spots, he is in severe danger, really, of advancing after four events in a bit of trouble for Dan Bailey. Not the spot we'd expect him to see.
And is it even harder when you're like feel like you're fighting, like to get in the game, get in the zone?
Yeah, sure. I mean, I'm giving everything I have, and that's all I'm going to do. And you get beat, you get beat. But I don't plan on doing that right now. I don't plan on losing. So.
How many times have you been to the regionals?
Three times.
And how many times have you entered the Open?
Three times.
And how many times have you been to the game?
Zero times. Until this weekend.
Second.
A second?
Yeah.
So you guys were the two fastest times?
Yeah.
Wow. And do you know what place you're in now overall?
Fourth.
Any stress off?
No.
Are you just saying that or is it true?
No, there's no stress off until Sunday afternoon. There's still two workouts to go, so.
Your celebration, is it just like you don't even know it's coming? No. Like you just cross the finish line and then you just explode?
Yeah, just the adrenaline kicks in again, you know, like you obviously give it all you have out there. But like gosh, and you like once the last bar was dropped, I was just like the adrenaline comes back and it's hard for me to keep it in.
You seemed happy when you finished. Do you wish you would have beat Josh now in hindsight?
Oh, of course I wish I would have beat Josh. Just doing everything I could to do it. You know, we did that in training. He saw my time, I saw his, you know, it was kind of whatever. He was about 10 seconds faster when we did it in training. I could always beat him off the run in the the deadlifts, but I can't do GHGs as fast as he can. I got to a point, it's like, this is it, as fast as I can go. I think I started about 5 ahead of him on the last round, and he just blew by me. I thought I might be able to get him on the deadlifts if he would have had to stop, but, you know, he powered through him, so.
What will tonight look like for you?
Get the brief, go back to the hotel, take a cold shower, throw the, like, some stem on or something, and then get some food with the folks. Don't talk about CrossFit.
I'll go get some body work done, eat a little food, relax, go to bed.
Watch a movie?
Yeah, I'll watch some TV, relax. I like to zone out on some weird TV, like Big Bang or something. Something that doesn't make me think.
Will you wake up sore?
Yeah.
I almost messaged you on Instagram saying, hey, I'm withdrawing from the competition.
Why did you change your mind?
I don't know. I went in the ocean. The waves, like, battled me around a little bit, and I started feeling better, so.
On Friday, you spoke about, I don't want to misquote you, but basically about, you know, this is going to be a humbling experience.
Yeah, it's an experience you can't buy. So yesterday, somebody was talking about somebody else out there not being able to deadlift to 405 one time. And you can look at that negatively or positively, right? Very rarely are you gonna be at the point of failure in front of thousands of people in your lifetime. And most of the time you would wanna hide that from experiencing it. So, I don't know, I view all experiences as just an experience, and I want experiences. So if something doesn't go optimally out there, then that's a beautiful experience in my existence. And I want them all. So that's why I'm here.
Before one of the events, you were putting your arms out like this.
Oh yeah, so
like a bird.
So through lots of meditation, I have gained the ability to gather power. And it's just this very specific pose that I do. If I'm in a forest or something, it's really powerful. But yeah, that's why I did that. It's just this, in my heart, I can just feel the energy of the room, right? So I was just taking that in for a second.
Some may say you're running away with it.
Never. Never over. It's never over till it's over. A lot of work left to be done.
Bill Grundler says that you, a Josh Bridges that can deadlift 405 like that, should send shivers to all the games athletes going to the games this year. That's like a really, really big, scary thing you did yesterday.
I don't know. I don't know if I wouldn't say it's that scary, but I'm excited for this year.
Let's look at this from, will you hit play on that? Let's look at this from 2013.
Oh, there I am. I threw my belt. He wasn't, and my glasses. I was angry. He's an angry elf. It's all right. I came back on that next workout and still did all right.
3 years ago, you had shorter hair. and you didn't have a 405 deadlift.
Well, I mean, I did 13. 13 of the 15 reps.
Did that haunt you?
No. I mean, it was embarrassing.
you know, that was, I think, the most part. I was just embarrassed that I went out there and unprepared, you know, and that's, for me, I felt just embarrassed. And so I just said to myself, I'd never let it happen again. So since then, I've worked on it, just waiting for that time when Dave would throw it into a workout, and got the opportunity yesterday, so it's good.
You use the word unprepared. Is that your military background speaking through?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
Because how can you prepare for everything in the CrossFit Games?
Yeah, it's really hard. It's really, really hard. But I think if you train hard enough and train smart enough, you should be prepared for everything that Dave can throw at you. Or at least to the point where you can rely on your athleticism at a certain point. But for something like a deadlift, like, that's something you can prepare for. And I wasn't ready for it, and so I should have been.
Were you a good SEAL?
That's not for me to decide. That's for my my brothers to decide.
When you look at the leaderboard, what goes through your mind?
Trying to get caught up in it.
Do you still get caught up in it?
No, not really, actually. Looked at it a few times yesterday, kind of just in, I guess, like, in disbelief. And just made sure it was still there. That it didn't change while I was sleeping in the middle of the night.
Just trying to stay lighthearted.
This guy's about to shit himself right now. No. Sitting in third position, sitting in a qualifying position. I can imagine what's going on to this guy's head.
Is he all fucked up right now?
No.
Dancing, dude.
Not even close.
His brain probably looks like fucking Hurricane Katrina right now.
Is this the best you've ever done at the regionals?
It is. It is. I finished 7th 1 year in the Mid-Atlantic. And that was like back, I feel like, not saying athletes weren't fit back then, but just the combination of the regions and how regionals has evolved is, I feel like it's just a different animal nowadays. So yeah, this is the best I've ever competed.
See?
While you were sleeping.
Is he getting cocky?
He's scared.
Nobody knows me. You know? So it's like,
there's a random guy
sitting in third.
How many hours a day did you spend trying to go to the games?
I guess it kind of depends on my schedule. If I'm working, I mean,
24.
Yeah.
24 is the answer. Yeah. If I'm not training for it, I'm thinking about it.
Is it really like that?
Yeah. I mean, I'll train literally like 2 sessions a day, like 2-hour sessions minimum. And then, I mean, we're neighbors. So if I hear weights in his garage moving when I'm walking my dog, I'll go in and do something, whether it's like a bike workout or just like a bodyweight movement to just breathe. And then with Josh, he has like a running group text message. So I feel like if somebody does something, one of us is going to go in our garage and go work out. So I feel like I probably train about 5 or 6 hours out of the day broken up. And then when I'm not training, I'm thinking about what I didn't do or what I could be doing tomorrow.
Will you win the games this year?
That's the goal. That's the goal. I mean, I feel like I have the opportunity to. You know, if I go out and next 8-9 weeks, you know, obviously everything's got to go well in these last 2 events. But, you know, I have to prepare myself for what else is out there for the games now. You know, the games is a different beast than regionals. So I just have to make sure I'm prepared for all those events as well. You know, you got your swimming and endurance events that are running actually outside somewhere possibly. You never know what Dave's going to throw. So as long as the next 8 weeks or 9 weeks or whatever it is so the games go well, I feel like I have the opportunity to do it.
Ronnie, you have a very notorious, and I use the word notorious probably the first time it's ever been used correctly, moment with a judge from many years ago. I can't remember what event it was. It was some chick judge. There was a shove or a bump and a ghost bar, a flying bar.
I remember it differently.
Okay. But now I see you out there smiling with your judge. Is there a new Ronnie? Is it a different situation? Is it
You mentioned something that was 10 seconds of my life.
Right.
4 years ago.
Correct.
And really, to me, that's all it is.
Right.
The fact that it's on the internet, hundreds of thousands of people watch it.
Is it really that many?
Yeah. I don't read the comments. I don't click on my name on the internet. So for me, that's all it is. It's 10 seconds of my life 4 years ago. Have I evolved as a person? Of course. I like to think that every day I evolve as a person. Am I completely different now than I was then? I don't know. It doesn't really matter. Yeah, I don't fixate on negative things. You know, they don't even exist to me. Negative things about myself don't exist. I don't regret anything I've ever done in my life. Anything. Zero regrets. You know, that 10-second thing that happened 4 years ago is just it's a non-issue for me about how I live my life today. And that's really why I'm here right now, is for now.
Wasn't that sort of a manifestation of your passion as a competitor and to want to win? Has that gone away?
Yeah, I can explain all different angles that put me in a good light. I just, I never felt the need to, so I never have. And I'm not going to do it now.
Does winning mean less to you now than it did 4 years ago?
You're really wanting me to explain what happened. I can tell you that it's a lot deeper of an issue than the competition. A lot deeper. You're talking about a judge who was in a competing gym of mine. There might have been some members switching back and forth. And that's all I'm going to say, is that it was deeper than the level of competition. But I really don't want to drag her name back into this, right? Because she doesn't need that, those emotions back in her life. Right?
Fair enough.
Yeah.
So have you looked at the leaderboard?
Yeah. Checked it out.
You're kind of at this like gatekeeper's status.
I know, man. I know. I'm trying to keep them out.
There's a collision occurring.
Ah. I like collisions.
There's four or five guys vying for two spots.
Let's duke it out. I'm ready.
How do you perform under pressure?
Just worry about myself. Do what I can do. I do that to the best of my abilities. Come out on top.
When you look forward into your year, like, do you see yourself like at the games? Like, is that like part of your plan? Okay, in July, then to July, I'm going to the games. And
honestly, those thoughts just started creeping in the last 24 hours. Yeah. Prior to this, prior to the Open, I was like, I don't even know if I'll do the Open. And the Open happened. And to be honest, there's so much going on in my personal life that I didn't know if regionals was going to happen. It's happening. And then there's like Sunday, I'm in contention for a spot, so now I'm thinking, okay, that might happen. But we'll cross that bridge when it comes.
When you look at these workouts, do you see them something you would excel at?
Yeah, like I said, CrossFit, I excel at CrossFit, and this is what it is, the CrossFit Games, right?
Going into the weekend, were there any workouts you looked at that you were like particularly interested in taking a bite out of?
I feel like every workout is something that any of the top five guys, top six guys can win. So every workout I look to win. It's not just one I'm focused on.
This one made for you?
Yes. This was made for me. I was made for this one.
You were?
Yeah.
Are you hungry?
For a win or for some food?
For a win.
For a win, that would be great. Made for me is relative. It means I will do well for me. How will I do well compared to everybody else? We'll see.
You're in 10th, I think, now. Do you still have your head in it at all? Like, are you thinking, or like?
Yeah, my head's in it. My head is to go out there and do my absolute best, crush it. And it's going to take some people making a mistake, you know? And that's okay. I don't want anybody to make a mistake necessarily, but if they do, I wouldn't mind taking advantage of it.
What's Chris saying to you today?
Push the pace, want it, and stay focused on one movement at a time. So today, when I hop on the assault bike, Don't think about the rest of the workout, just think about what's happening on the assault bike. Walk over, think about what's happening on the handstand walk. Just one movement at a time.
When you see his current placement, do you think he can go to the CrossFit Games?
I think he can. I know his potential, and I know his ability on these two workouts, and I think I know a lot can happen in two workouts, and if he gets in the top three on both of these, a lot can happen down the leaderboard. I'll make it simple. If I take first place in both workouts, my chances are pretty good, I think. So that's the goal today. Not to be like too conceited or anything, but
Let's just make it, no doubt, first places.
Having a good time, man.
Are you pretty pumped up?
Yeah, man.
Did you come here wanting to go to the game?
Of course.
Yeah, of course.
Came out of the woodwork, trying to let the training speak for itself, the hard work and the fun.
Are you surprised at all that you're just like that? You can see the games from where you stand right now.
Yeah, I mean, who wouldn't? Especially being this new and you know having to kind of almost at my fingertips if I have a good two events. But yeah, just trying to still be me, have a little dancing out there, and you know, keep smiling.
So, how old are you?
26.
And how long have you been doing CrossFit?
Last year was my very first year.
And what athletic discipline do you come from?
I played basketball all the way up until high school, and I actually competitively snowboarded for a couple years. I do have a strength conditioning background with going to college for a kinesiology degree and working at sport performance facilities and whatnot.
And how tall are you?
5'10 on a good day.
And how much do you weigh?
185.
And having a background in kinesiology and sort of this athletic background, was it hard to embrace CrossFit? Like thinking you might already know everything? Or?
No, not at all. I mean, it's just one of those things where you just kind of knew how the lifting and the barbell was going from teaching it for so long, but the whole grasping was the whole gymnastic movements. So it's about it. And the mobility for full squat cleans and full squat snatches and all that kind of stuff. Because most sport performance stuff had a lot of power position. So, yeah.
Coach?
Yes, coach, training partner, friend.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And what's the name of your gym that you come from?
CrossFit Lumberyard in Anaheim Hills.
Are you the owner?
No, I'm not. He's actually the owner.
Gotcha.
Owner. Beard behind the lumberyard.
Awesome.
Big Trouble in Little China. You ever seen it, Sevan?
Yeah. Kurt Russell.
This is Jack Burton's tank top, bro, for that movie.
That's a great fucking movie.
Right? I'm trying to harness my inner Jack Burton for this workout.
Are you old enough to even know about that movie?
Bro, I'm one of the oldest cats in this line.
What?
I'm one of the oldest guys in this line.
10 seconds.
And Garrett's the youngest guy in this line.
They're all children compared to you.
Right. 7, 2, 1, go.
Get it, Josh!
One more event. It's not over yet.
I was just coach failing my first test.
Dude, I was still hard. This guy and I, we did it twice, the workout. Every single time was like that. Like, bang, bang, bang.
You beat me both times.
All three times?
Three times, actually, yeah. But I mean, he was taking his sweet time up here. I was about to pick up the bar before him, but I was like, nah, I owe him this. I don't want to take it from him.
How's Garrett going to do on the next workout?
Dude, I'm afraid he's going to do really well.
Yeah?
Like, really well. He's going to take top three. Yeah, I think so. He's going to rope climbs.
You seem the least stressed of all the guys. Are you stressed inside, or?
I don't think so. I lost last year. I was really nervous last year. This year, I mean, no, not really. I've been watching movies every night, just taking easy. I started a little bit this morning. I mean, it's been pretty calm for me.
What did you do this morning?
Studying. I went to the coffee shop and studied a little bit.
For school?
Yeah, for school.
What are you taking? What are you studying?
Philosophy, English, and wellness class. I mean, honestly, it's kind of nice to get the thoughts away from CrossFit.
You did great. The question is did you beat the right guys?
I beat some of the right guys, and then a couple of the guys that I didn't want to beat me got me by a place, so it'll shuffle things up. But
is your thumb bleeding?
No, that's red tape by Rock Tape.
Oh, gotcha.
Shout out to a sponsor.
How'd that look, Sevan?
I thought it looked great.
Thank you.
Did you feel good?
Felt awesome.
That was just a warm-up for the last workout.
Yeah, exactly. Nice long warm-up for that sprint. Kids call that active recovery nowadays.
Do you have any idea what the placement is now?
No, I know that I was top five on that workout, so that'll put me in a good spot for that last workout, all or nothing.
Is there like a specific strategy in order to win?
I mean, yeah, always finish in the top three or so, I mean,
okay.
Yeah.
And what is your strategy going into the last event?
Go as hard as I can.
Go as hard as you can, all right, yep. Awesome. Thank you.
Dave, is Dan out? Is Dan out?
Fair enough. Number one or number two, do you know?
I don't know what he's doing, if he's taking a piss or a shit, but I did see him go in here.
It's cool.
Not us.
Is he taking a deuce?
No, he's washing his hands. I noticed it's mostly games athletes on those teams, you know? It's games athletes. But I'm wondering, you know? I'm just wondering. What do I gotta do?
Do you have a relationship with him?
With Dave?
Yeah.
I know Dave pretty well.
We can believe that. Ben Alderman.
He's not even Mexican.
Warrior CrossFit.
He looked Mexican, but he's Filipino white.
Damn. You think of Charlie?
Charlie Zamora. Yeah.
Hey, what I gotta do to get on the demo team?
It starts with level one seminar staff. They get first priority.
Oh, they get first priority.
But if that doesn't work out, I'll keep you in mind.
Thanks, bro. Appreciate
I knew
it.
That you're Iron Mile. I just fucked that up. The camera scares me. I get nervous from the camera. Yeah, so the pressure. I know you're Iron Mile.
That's why none of his sex tapes have come out, because he gets nervous. You guys all kind of look alike. That's weird.
That is weird. I just met these dudes on the street. What's up, Matt? To me? Yeah. What's up, buddy? So good to see you, dudes.
You guys all go to the same beautician?
We do, yeah. We look good, right? We look good.
I'm pretty sure there's a sign that says athletes only.
Oh, yeah. These guys are athletes. They can climb 15 feet. I've seen it. Can't you?
Yeah. Woo-hoo!
My credentials. That basically lets me get back here. Lets me get back here.
Did I win for this? No, it's not a medal. It's just a pass. All right, give me a hug. Wish me luck. I'll see you guys after. I'll see you guys after on the floor, okay? I love you. Cheer loud, okay? Really loud. The loudest you ever have. Right, dude? All right, brother.
Well, that was
That's helpful.
That keeps the tension going.
Right? Yeah, it's good.
I interviewed him right before, and he said, yeah, I just need to just, I don't want to be cocky, but I just need to go out there and get two first place.
That's a good game plan.
did he go over with that one with you first, or is he gone rogue?
He's gone rogue. I mean, he knows. I didn't tell him. I don't know. I'm learning, because I know how I was, you know? So, yeah. I just told him he needs to show up.
On that last workout, you took any risks?
I went hard? I was hurting. There's really no risk. Just to pick up that bar as fast as you could. I guess you could say that, but no, I just pushed it.
By risk, I mean, you know, redline and get stuck somewhere.
I didn't worry about that when I was doing it. I wanted to win the workout.
Same here with this one?
Yep, same plan. Yeah.
Just go.
I'm gonna go balls to the wall right now. It's so tight. There's no mistakes, no mistakes.
Yeah, yeah, it's good.
I got you.
I know you got.
I thought you stepped back. I was like, yeah.
I saw you making some pretty intense eye contact with your judge on the thrusters.
Did you get no rep or something? You just want to make sure.
You know, sometimes you just play games with people.
Yeah. So you just have
no hard feelings. Yeah. I was just locking it out for sure.
Did you get a no rep?
Yeah, he kept on no repping me, so. I just gave him 3 second lockouts.
Right.
Awesome experience.
What's the rest of your day look like?
Watching the sunsets, mandatory.
Whoa. Will you stick around and watch the rest of the event?
Yeah. The guys in the last heat are insane. I feel like a spectator out there just on the floor though, you know, doing what they do, feeling what they feel. Cause I'm in awe of them.
Thank you, Castro.
You have fun?
Thank you for all this, yeah.
You did great. You were fun to watch.
Thanks.
You're always entertaining.
Thanks.
Are you thinking about going over, maybe giving Dan a pep talk?
Nope. I don't think he needs that. It's not my place. That's not my place.
I don't know if he's going to make it. The other athletes around are solid. I just don't know if he's going to be able to do it. Bums me out. But, I mean, he can surprise everyone, too. I mean, there's so much that can happen, but I just don't know if this is going to be the best event for him to make that happen.
But I will have a, if everything goes wrong and something happens and he doesn't make it, I will have a beer with him. A lot of them.
Do you feel bad at all for busting Hank's balls now that he choked?
Nah, it's just playful banter, you know, we were just having a good time. I mean, Hank's a good buddy. We've been training together for 3 years, so if he expected anything less, that would be weird.
If he doesn't make it to the games, will you still train with him?
Never. Of course, man. Of course.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. That didn't happen in training, but shit happens. So
in training, that never happened?
No, I just couldn't find the right position. I don't know. I also didn't fall as many times in training on the handstand walk. So I think like just the extra amount of work, maybe. I don't know. I couldn't get in the right position. It felt terrible. The second five obviously felt like
185. So,
what do you think about this guy's performance? This guy, Hank Lopez.
I mean, awesome. You know, it's cool to see some newcomers on the scene and guys just throwing down like that. And I always appreciate guys a little smaller as well.
5'4".
Yeah, right? I'm in good company, man.
You're tall.
A giant, like almost a half an inch taller.
Do you end up getting in your head as this shit starts falling apart out there?
No, I just kind of get really, sometimes I don't really do positive self-talk. I tend to, there's a lot of name calling that goes on inside of my head. So.
Even out there?
All the time, yeah. I kind of give myself a little tough love. I know, kind of the way I came up, all my buddies and whatnot, we're pretty hard on each other, so I'm always pretty hard on myself. So when I start failing, I get really, really hot. There's no positive self-talk. Usually a lot of name-calling. So.
Can you win this next workout?
Absolutely.
You're in third place, but there's only like 15 points separating.
Not enough. Yeah.
There's five guys fighting for four places.
Yeah. That's right. Really, five guys fighting for three places.
Can you win the workout?
Can I win it?
Yeah.
Yeah. I can. I gotta be smart. I gotta not be afraid.
How do you manage the rope climbs? You go, I mean, because you can't fail, right?
No. Got to push it a little bit, and it's a time to take a risk, you know?
You have such a good lead right now. Then do you think that it's worth taking a big risk on this just to really run it home?
What do you mean, big risk?
Like, so like someone like Marcus Philly or Dan have to take some risks, like maybe get on the rope faster than they want to. Is this something you would do too, just to fucking just...
I'm going to go hard. I'm going to go as hard as I can. Yeah, I don't want to lose. I hate losing.
I don't mean just lose, I mean get on the road, like, really, really push it. Until, like, hey, I'm not sure if I'm ready, but...
Yeah, I think so. I think if I need to, I will.
Yeah.
So,
3, 1, 2, 1.
Legs, no legs.
Legs.
You had an incredible showing, event number 2, Tommy V.
Thank you.
Crushed it.
Oh, so you make a comparison now to this workout?
Yeah, is this a gift?
Don't.
Is this a gift for you?
No, it's really not. Like, to be completely honest, like, legless rope climb and rope climb for me is two different ball games. My rope climb games is fine, but legless, to be honest, it's not that great. So, I'm not expecting to do anything crazy out here. I'm just hoping we can be in the middle of the pack and then go to Carson.
Are you just gonna come out? Is this just a sprint?
Yeah, you know what? At this point, I've gotta put everything in my back pocket, including the watch out for the puck.
Thank you.
Anything, everything. Let it go for a little less than 3 minutes, you know?
Are you comfortable doing that with rope climbs?
Definitely. Definitely. It's actually, it's not about comfort. Let's get uncomfortable and have some fun.
How many regionals have you been in?
Last year was my first year at CrossFit, and last year I made my regional, so this is my second regional.
How's it feel to be in the final heat over and over and over?
It's pretty,
I don't have one.
It's something else. It's something else, definitely moving myself up throughout the weekend and getting there, you know?
Awesome, thanks, man. Thank you.
Bailey, 3 points out.
of that fifth place position. He needs to do well here. And the last time we had a rope climb event, he did do pretty well in this event. So he needs to shine. Like you said, Brandon, if he wins this event, he clinches the spot. But man, we have so many things that are up for grabs. Right ahead of him is Christian Lucero. Now these guys were almost identical in the rope climb events when they had this. If we look exactly back to those events, Dan Bailey's time on that 10 rope climb event was 4 minutes 10 seconds. Christian's Lucero was 4 minutes 30 seconds, so it's going to be very, very close.
Keep in mind the point structure. The top six are separated by 5 points each. Beyond that, it's 2 points from 7th to 30th, and 1 point beyond that. Here we go, the last heat of the weekend here in SoCal. It's underway, and expect fireworks.
So 21-15-9 thrusters, 3-2-1 legless rope climbs, 95 pounds on the bar, 6 minute time cap, and a bunch of fire burning up the floor.
Do you have any thoughts whether you think it's enough?
I don't know.
We've got the results. They're hot off the press. In first, it's Josh Bridges. In second, it's Rasmus Weisbeck Anderson. In third, with 549 points, Marcus Philly. In fourth, with 548 points,
So Josh Bridges a year ago was out. Dan Bailey a year ago was the champion. Flip it this year. Josh Bridges the champion in California. Dan Bailey, for the first time since 2010, won't be at the games.
Yeah, that's. I mean, it's shocking, but it's just as shocking as when Josh didn't make it. But look what happened when Josh didn't make it. He came back with a vengeance, so maybe we'll see the same type of thing coming from Dan.
Hey, you're awesome, man. Good job.
Hey, and I'm going to take you up on training.
All right.
And a couple months.
All right.
What you thinking, Dan?
Disappointed.
What are you gonna do now?
What do you mean?
Eat, drink, sleep. Why the tears at the end?
Honestly, 2 weeks ago, I sold the gym that I built 5 years, left my community without a clear idea of what I was gonna do next. It just felt like the right time. My mom and my dad were here this weekend. My mom celebrated her 64th birthday yesterday, 1 year post-cancer treatment. My grandfather passed away yesterday on my mom's birthday. And it's been 2 years since I've been on this stage in front of all these people, and the culmination of just emotions and nerves and just doing what I've trained hard to do, it's just hard to contain those emotions at the end. And I think mostly what stands out is just the feeling of the support of my family, knowing what my grandmother's going through right now with her husband of over 50 years who passed away yesterday, and they're with the rest of my family right now doing what's probably most important, and I get to be here continuing to do what I love to do for a lot of really, really important people in my life that are still here with me. That's all.
Oh, well, well.
Turned out okay, huh?
Just another 3 days of training.
Another easy weekend, light weekend, right?
What are you feeling?
I'm excited for sure. Excited that that everything turned out the way we wanted it to, that the training's been paying off, that we've been doing the right things. It's obviously always reassuring when you're putting that much of yourself into something that you're doing it the right way and you're putting into the right things. But again, I'm kind of like just fired up to get back in the gym too and just start working my ass off for StubHub Center.
What will your training look like from now until the games?
Considering I don't have a home gym anymore, I'm gonna maybe come down here and bunk up with Garrett. He says he's got a couch for me. Train with those guys. I don't know. It's maybe a good time to just change things up in my life and see where things land me, you know?
So that was the most stressful weekend I've had in a long, long time. A lot of highs and a lot of lows.
What were the lows?
Day two. Just the whole day two was. It's just because I did well in event three, the pull-up wall ball one. But then even though I came close to PRing that pistol one, but my best effort wasn't even near the top. And so I was pretty disappointed in that one. And then going into the runny one, I was like, that's a good event for me, but I knew right away on the first GHDs that my legs had nothing left in them. And I didn't perform as well as I wanted to. And then going from second place at the end of the first day to eighth, it's pretty disappointing. But I woke up and I was like, I'm gonna go for it today. Cause I saw, no give me inspiration, was Con Porter. I think he was like eighth place going into the third day, and he brought it. And I was like, dude, that like inspired me a little
He's
bit.
He's like the Australian Garrett Fisher.
A little bit. I met him this year at ECC. He actually was on my team. He's a cool guy, but I saw that happen. I was like, dude, that like inspired me a little bit.
When you crossed the finish line, did you know you were going to the games?
I had a good feeling that that I was, but then again, I just, you know, ran my race, worked my ass off, finished where I wanted to finish. You know, if I went to the games or not, I was happy with that, and I was excited about my performance. That's all I wanted to do coming to day three was put on a show, put on a, like my best performances, and if that was enough, awesome. If it wasn't, I was going to be happy with wherever that left me. My team competed this morning, and they worked their asses off. They bled on this floor, and they came up one spot shy, but I was so fucking proud of them and how they fought. That's all I wanted. I wanted to fucking fight just as hard as they did, and where the chips fell, that's where they fell. I was okay with that.
You told me going into that second to last workout, I said, what do you need to do? You're like, I need two first places.
Yeah.
And I said, well, what are you gonna do? You're like, well, I don't mean to be cocky, but I'm gonna do it. Did you really believe that, or do you have to fake it till you make it, or how does that work?
No, I believed it. I put some extreme work in, like, literally like a week after the regionals last year, I made a commitment to get back to the games, reached out to Chris, and he helped me the whole way through, and I've worked my ass off the whole entire year. Like, every single day, like, I came in the gym, mobilized, did what I need to do, put a little extra work in. I didn't take a single day off, so I knew I had the capabilities, and Chris, like, he helped me the whole way through. Like, he just believe, and yeah, I don't know, it's a good feeling right now.
Just let me know what you need. Yeah, I'm just gonna chill. At least take 3 days.
Like, I think maybe towards the end, maybe Friday.
Yeah, I'll kinda get some light stuff on Thursday.
Yeah. Are you guys coach and athlete, or friend and friend? Which comes first?
Friend and friend, for sure. Yeah, friend and friend. He's more of a friend. Honestly, like, he's a spectacular coach, but I consider him a friend before anything.
Is it hard to take pointers from someone being that you're at such a high level?
Not at all. No. He's like the Master Yoda. Like, he's been in the game so many times. Like, he's an OG. OG. Like, I've been doing CrossFit for a while, and he's one of the first names I ever knew about.
Who do you train with? Who's elite?
My whole team, they came to regionals. So they're all team regional athletes. We have a guy on our team, Brian Diaz, who made the games a few years ago. And then Dan Bailey comes in. Since we're at Costa Mesa, he drops in a lot because he's with Progenix. And then we have a good, healthy, like, influx of Progenix athletes come through every once in a while. But for the most part, it's just me and my team at CrossFit Costa Mesa.
Is that enough?
Yes, definitely. I don't think that it's necessarily essential to be training with other games athletes all the time. I think as long as you find a family, a group that pushes you to be the best that you can do every day and be the best that you can be every day, that's what you need more so than the name or the celebrity that you're training with, because that doesn't really get you anything. You want that constant push every day from somebody that you love, and you want to kind of form that bond. I think that goes a lot further than just training with somebody that, you know, has a name in the sport.
What's the biggest obstacle besides physical performance in getting to the games?
Yeah. That mental toughness. It takes a lot of mental toughness all year long to come to the gym every single day and grind. Not every day is your best day, but if you have the mental toughness, like, I'm just going to put in the work no matter what, you're going to get better. I think that's the biggest thing. It's not physical capabilities. Yes, it is. Like, talent helps, but it's not hard work.
Just turned 23.
Do you feel any toll that this is taking on your body, pushing this hard?
No, we push very hard in training. This is kind of, with the intensity that we train, this is one of our tapered weeks. So this is one of our more mellow weeks as far as volume is concerned. My coach is used to having us doing, you know, these kind of regional prep weekends with 7, 6 to 8 hour days on the Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So my body's pretty used to the volume. This is a little bit lower, but the intensity, of course, goes up. So there's a little switch there.
How about your sister's performance this weekend? Is that inspiring?
Dude, I love my sister. She crushed it. She's grown up with three older brothers. She's so competitive, and she hates losing. And to see her go out there and just perform and crush the competition and do so well every single event was pretty cool.
Does your shit get mixed up with her shit? Like, if she's not doing well, does it bring you down? Or if you're not doing well, does it bring
down? No, not at all. We're all separate. I know if she has a bad day, like, I'll text her, like, keep your head up. She texts me every single day. It was like, today's your day. Like, let's go. So, I mean, it's pretty cool that we both made it. Yeah, we actually been wanting to be doing that since we started. I think that was like 2012 was our first year competing together.
That'll just be like the cherry on top, you know? all right, here's how you stack up kind of thing, but
it's just enjoying what I do. That's all I'm really
I think it's my mustache.
There's cameras hovering all around the athlete area.
Yeah.
Is that hard to deal with, having all of us?
No, the funny thing about it, I was telling Chris, I was like, I'm so glad like I don't have a camera following me around.
That's because, what I mean.
Yeah, so like I didn't have no cameras following me around, no pressure, because I mean I haven't made the games back in 2 years. So it was kind of nice to kind of you guys are a distraction. At the end of the day,
that's
you guys are a
I mean.
Distraction.
Is that
like
hard?
People say it's oh it's not it's fine, it's not a big deal. At the end of the day, it's a distraction.
It is
yeah.
a big deal.
Yeah.
Yeah. How do you manage that? How do you manage it? I mean, because you are always, everyone's always cooperating with us. How do you manage the camera?
I mean, you be polite and know that this is kind of build your brand. So you know you gotta put a, you gotta say what's up and talk to them, but at the same time not be rude about it.
Right.
But not at the same time, you're here for a reason. And if they're in the way, to be like, hey, not to disrespect you, but I gotta go warm up or do whatever you need to do.
How emotional was that to see Dan not make it?
You know what? I didn't think he was gonna make it anyway. It was hard to see him come close to failing on the rope. And then it's always hard to see a good athlete not make it, but that's sports too.
Do we have a games winner out of this region? Josh Bridges. And who are you? Did you immediately compare him to Ben Smith and Matt Frazier? Is that what you do? You're like, okay.
No, you know what's funny is I don't compare him to those guys. It depends on the workouts that come out. Like, he did really well on these events here, but and they were heavy, which was good. I don't know. I think he's definitely, like, he definitely could be a podium person. I mean, he looked unbelievable. So I think he's definitely podium worthy. As far as winning, I mean, in reality, I don't know if I would pick Ben Smith or even Matt Frazier to be the winner. I think that they're all in the mix, but it really depends on the workouts and how everyone's handling it.
Hank Lopez could have gone to the games. He did those final overhead squats like as good as anybody.
I don't know what happened on the first part. I don't know what happened on the first 10. I mean, all I know is that when every time we looked back there, he was dropping the bar. So I don't know if it was a stability thing. I don't know if he just wasn't warm yet. But yeah, he made the last 5 look ridiculously easy.
You look so different with your hair like this, like almost like mad scientist.
I kept saying to myself, I don't have time to look pretty. I'm just trying to be fit.
Is your mad scientist look more you, or is the clean cut version more you?
I would say this is probably more me. A little crazy. Someone called me belligerent. They're like, you look belligerent. I was like, I like that. I'll take that. I'll be belligerent. I've been called worse.